Hey everybody, my name is Jared and I am a Master Mason in the state of Mississippi in the United States of America. And y'all have to let me know, is the tie working for the show? I normally don't wear a tie on the show. Today I'm trying out the Sprig of Acacia tie from Edgar Alejandro over at Masonic Revival. He's got a whole series of things with the Sprig of Acacia and it looks really darn sharp. But you let me know, what do you think? Is the tie working it for the show? Today's viewer's question is, if you have any general knowledge about the Order of the Eastern Star organization, I would appreciate a video. Maybe compare and contrast them with regular Masons. Well, let me thank you for phrasing that the way that you did, because general knowledge is about all I have. I am a member of the Order of the Eastern Star, and I'm currently serving as Marshal in my local chapter. However, I've only been a member for about 2 years, and for the first year I wasn't very active at all. I was just way too busy with home life stuff. But now I've gotten very active with it again, and I'm enjoying learning, so I can share with you a little bit of history about where it even came from, and I can give you a little bit of that compare and contrast that you're looking for. So one thing that's a bit unique about the Order of the Eastern Star is there's no mystery or debate about its origin. So in Freemasonry, you can have people who say, look, it started in 1720, plain and simple. You have people who say it started in 1717, plain and simple. You have people who say, well, it goes back to the stonemason guilds. We know it went back to 1300 or 1100 or something to that effect. Or then we have people who say, no, it goes all the way back to King Solomon himself. And you have people who say, no, it goes back to Noah. And you have people who say, it's been there ever since the time of Adam. So just depending on who you ask, you could debate all day long about the origins of Freemasonry. The Order of the Eastern Star, however, was developed and initiated by a man named Dr. Rob Morris right here in the great state of Mississippi. So it just happens that last weekend before filming this video, my wife and I attended an awesome event over at the Little Red Schoolhouse just north of Jackson, Mississippi, in a town just outside of a town called Pickens, Mississippi. The Little Red Schoolhouse is where Dr. Rob Morris was the principal. It started off as a general schoolhouse, became a Masonic university, and during the time that Rob Morris was working there as the principal, he came up with what we know today as the Order of the Eastern Star. So there's no two bones about it, but depending on who you ask, it is generally considered a very beautiful and meaningful degree work. So obviously in any Masonic related organization, there are people who have their favorites. But generally speaking, people who've been through the Order of the Eastern Star say, wow, that was pretty impactful and had a lot of meaning behind it. So something that's perhaps a little bit different is that in regular Freemasonry, as you call it, you're familiar with the idea of going through a series of degrees. So you go to the first degree, you learn some things, you prove a proficiency in that degree, and then you're able to move on to the next one, and so on, until you receive your master's degree, and then you can potentially join other organizations if you're interested, etc. Over in the Eastern Star, I have heard it referred to several times as degrees. Specifically, there are five, and they relate to the 5 points on a five-pointed star. But of 5 degrees, if you will, they are all conferred in one night in the same ceremony. So when you go through and receive your degrees, it wouldn't really come to your mind that you just went through 5 different degrees, because it's one ceremony, so to speak. But there are 5 different lessons to learn, and again, I hear them termed in the Eastern Star as degrees. So what are these degrees? Well, they're related to 5 heroines or females in the Holy Bible, and most people are aware that in the Holy Bible we can read a million different men's names, but references to women or what the women were doing are kind of slim and far and few between. But here in Dr. Morris's Order of the Eastern Star, We have five different heroines, one of which isn't given by name in the Bible. It's just a reference to someone, and so the name is a little bit interesting. But let's start and give them in the order that they would in the Eastern Star. They are Adah, whose lesson is centered around the blue-colored point of the star. Ruth's, whose lesson is centered around the yellow-colored point of the star. Ester, around the white point of the star. Martha, around the green point. And Electa, referencing to the elected, on the red point of the star. So each one of these heroines obviously went through a story in the Bible. I'll let you go and read about it yourself. And the Eastern Star gets a moral lesson out of that and conveys it over to their members. So that generally is what you're looking at. And some other differences, at least with my Blue Lodge here locally. I don't think this is a universal difference. Music is very much incorporated into regular business meetings and degree work with the Order of the Eastern Star. With my lodge, nobody ever touches a piano or an organ or any other instrument. So it was definitely a bit of a culture change when I went from just going to the Blue Lodge by myself to attending Eastern Star with my wife. I thought, oh wow, that piano actually gets used over in that corner. So there's something there. Something else that is perhaps unique, let me step into it a different way. To be a member of the Order Eastern Star, you have to show some type of affiliation with a Master Mason. Now, that could be your four times great grandfather, it could be your four times great uncle, it could be your husband, it could be your son. So there's many different things that are accepted and very lenient, if you will, documentation that's required to prove that. Obviously, if we're talking about your four times great grandfather, there might be very little documentation to try to show that you had a Master Mason in your family. So really, the only thing I can tell you, the only right answer is you've got to contact a local chapter or maybe the grand chapter in your state and ask them what qualifications are necessary and what kind of proof do you need to be able to provide. They'll be the ones that can actually answer that question for you. Inside of an Eastern Star chapter, you're going to find that there are several different positions, and each one of them has a specific role and duty. I'm not going to step into each one, but suffice to say, it's more than what I am used to seeing inside of a regular Blue Lodge in Freemasonry. So that was something else that I thought was a little bit interesting. But one thing that I know that is still a thing inside of Eastern Star that some people don't expect or don't know about, because generally speaking, the Eastern Star is considered to be the sorority of Freemasonry, as if it's the female version of regular Blue Lodge Freemasonry. But then when you get there, you find out there's a man. And why is there a guy here if we're holding a Eastern Star chapter? I thought this was a women's organization. Well, it just so happens that every chapter does have to have what is styled as the worthy matron and a worthy patron for each of their chapters. So in Blue Lodge, you have to have a worshipful master of the lodge, and he has wardens and so forth. But in the Order of the Eastern Star, you have to have the matron and the patron. And I think, though I don't know, I have not done any scholarly research on this whatsoever, but intuitively, it makes sense to me because we're learning lessons from the scriptures. We're talking about lessons out of the Holy Bible. We're talking about interactions between men and women in the Bible and the patriarchs and the matriarchs of families and groups of people. So it makes sense to me that in this organization we have the head figure being a woman, but the man figure has a point and a part in it as well. Almost all of the other chairs can be filled by women. There is an associate patron chair as well, but he's not required to be there for the chapter to actually open. But he still has to be there. And so the question that a lot of people have is, well, why? Why are we having this women's organization that has to have a man in it? And the answer is because it's not a sorority. It is an organization that is based off of biblical teaching. And in that, we see the patriarch and matriarch of a family, or the female and male head of some sort of group of people or organizations. So I think that's where it really boils down to. Lastly, I think probably the most inconsequential difference between regular Freemasons and the Order of the Eastern Star that I have noticed is, here in the United States, which has to be specified, we're going to have subordinate blue lodges in regular Freemasonry, and those blue lodges are answerable up to a grand lodge, which those blue lodges originally formed. So that's your hierarchy. At that grand lodge, which encompasses an entire state, there's no other higher authority. However, in the Order of the Eastern Star, it is an international organization. You're going to have your local chapter, a grand chapter over your state, and then you're going to have the international organization. So there is another level that is a bit higher, and the benefit there being that you're able to see the exact same ritual, the exact same lessons are being taught everywhere, whereas in Freemasonry it can differ a little bit from state to state, or in some areas even lodge to lodge. The benefit there being that the individual culture can show out, the same lessons are being taught, but perhaps explained and portrayed in a slightly different way, but with the end message being the same. So you can take it or leave it, but it is a difference that's worth noting. I hope that answers your question about the Order of the Eastern Star, and as I progress, maybe in a year or two, we might delve into this and do a full-out series about the Eastern Star, just like I have done with degrees over in regular Freemasonry. Thank you all so much for taking the time to watch, and don't forget to let me know about the tie. We'll see you next time. Bye.